A picture which brings back memories. There is one of the last of the Mumbles trains about to leave the old Rutland Street depot on its 5.5 miles journey along the shores of Swansea Bay to Oystermouth, Southend and Mumbles Pier.
The Mumbles Railway was not just an ordinary tram system. It went around the edge of a bay. It was special because it was the first passenger railway in the world. And it was special because it took people to their leisure time, to their enjoyment, not just taking them from their homes to their work, although it did some of that, of course. If they had a day off work, well, it was a great thing to do, trundle down to Mumbles. It was the high point of people's lives when life was a bit harder and holidays were shorter.
It was part of the community. It linked everyone together, each little station, you know, and it was superb. This is the Blackpool station, and it's the only station left of the Mumbles Railway. Everything was destroyed. Nothing was left at all after it closed in 1960.
This cab, I suppose, is the last piece of rolling stock from the Mumbles Railway. They cut the front off one of the tram cars. I think they were a little bit afraid of trying to preserve the whole thing. They were very big, you know, 200 sitting down in it. It was an industrial tramway when it was first built. It was originally built to carry coal, limestone, things like that. But then in 1807, a man called Benjamin French got the right to run a passenger service on it, and that made it the first passenger railway in the world. Horse-drawn, of course.
And they changed to steam in 1890, and that was successful, carrying 1,800 passengers at a time, the largest amount of passengers on any railway in Britain. And then it changed to electric, and it was carrying, when it closed, about 5 million passengers a year. Taken over by South Wales Transport. It was a bus company, and they decided they wanted the railway, and they wanted to run more buses, and they closed the railway. It was lost. We had a petition of up and 14,000 signatures, and they didn't take any notice. They said, no, the railway is to close. So it was closed in January 5th, 1960, to the sadness of Swansea.
They thought that people would travel by buses. Buses could move anywhere. A train or a tram was on its tracks. And they decided that to spend a lot of money on repairing it, which was apparently needed at the time, it wasn't worth it.
When the day before it closed, that was on the 4th, the evening, the people of Mumbles hired two electric cars, and they all dressed in black and widow's weeds. And in the evening, then, they carried a coffin through the streets of Mumbles, and they went down into to Swansea for the last trip, and that was the end of it.
...1960 was not the right time for preserving railways in many ways. I think if you ask the people of Swansea today, they would say it was a mistake. But it was hard to peer into the future.
Well, we have fought now for 20 years to try and bring back the Mumbles Railway as the first passenger railway. And with the Mumbles Road using 1 million cars a month on this road, it is chaotic. So I think they're going to have to bring some system of transport back to this part of Wales.
I don't think the Mumbles Railway will be rebuilt. There would be so many problems. I'd love to see it happen, but I'm a little sceptical, I'm afraid.